Today is the full review of one of the most exciting rock crawlers we've ever had the opportunity of assembling and running. So hang in there to find out more about the Boom Racing BRX01 LC70. Ready to runs, we modify the heck out of them, and our objective is to let you know the pros and cons of each vehicle to get you introduced into the hobby or get you trying another level, another category of the hobby. You know, spread the RC world and the rock crawling world in particular. Also, we have a Facebook group, RC Review, so consider getting in there because we release our videos there early and we do a lot of behind the scenes extra photos and videos. And if you need any of the products we talk about, click on the links in our description. That helps our channel out a little bit so we can buy more stuff like this. All right, so this is the Boom Racing BRX01 LC70. You know, I have an unboxing here. And as I said, at first I was a little concerned, you know, buying all the way from Asia, Hong Kong, $630 is a lot of money from a company, you know, that I didn't really know much about. You don't see a lot of these here, but it just blew us away. The next thing we did is the assembly of this thing, you know, bit by bit. And we talk about that in this video here. And now we actually have the body and we have test run video. That's what you want, right? So click to the end if you want just to see it run. But if you want me to tell you about what's going on with this kit and what makes it special, hang in there and I'll get to it. So first, let's talk about the body. So this is a hard body. So it's not Lexan like we're used to, that lightweight stuff. This is a real body. And what hard bodies allow you to do is to have the detail, the precision that mimics a real vehicle. So you're gonna have a whole new level of realism, and that's here in this LC70. The LC70 is not sold in the US by Toyota. It's in Australia and a bunch of other countries. It's a workhorse pickup truck. So it's a little long on the bed because it's meant to haul stuff. But it's also a very capable off-roader. And what they did is they wanted to capture the exact scale of this vehicle. So it is long, 12.3-inch wheelbase, so it's good for us, but it is narrow. And you have the hard body here. And, you know, something you don't see a lot in RCs is a deep pickup bed. So a very accurate pickup bed in depth. And it has these wheel bumps for your wheel arches. And it just adds to the realism because this adds a whole level of complexity for an RC car. Usually you'll have a pickup with super shallow bed, right? To leave room for your shocks. So here we go. It's a body by Killer Body. They have a very close relationship with that. So they throw it in the kit. And it is actually more difficult to assemble the body than the kit itself, because the kit is partially assembled already. And the body has hundreds of parts. Little wipers, you know, the mirror alone has a bunch of parts. So it is the most intense body ever. And it's nice too, right? The detail is amazing. So we painted it. This is gunmetal gray, and two layers of gunmetal gray and about five layers of clear coat. So this, I don't know, for some reason we wanted it shiny. You could either go shiny or workman truck type in this kind of vehicle. And so it took a lot of work, but I think it turned out pretty nice, huh? What do you guys think? So there you go. The bed is flat black, you know, very, very accurate, true to scale. So so many options for this, for just for the body alone. So we'll try we might cover that in another video, maybe on this one, but this video is probably gonna get too long, so we will probably cover another video. So here we go. To the body is attached by two pins here, and you lock it with a screw, so a little bit funky. And then once the screw is unlocked, it's not there right now, it's on a swivel mount. So there you go. And what's cool about the swivel mount, so you can work on it, change your battery and whatnot. What's cool and not cool about it is detachable. So you just lift it and boom, it's off. It's a lot easier to work on your body, especially something this heavy when it's off the vehicle. So there it is. So much room for light buckets and whatnot. The bed is hitting this part, so it makes a little bit of noise. Probably can put a little rubber liner there. The glass, the windshield is super clear, much clearer than Lexan. It's just a different plastic. Wow, this thing took a beating. Only one battery pack, and we kind of abused it. So, and here's the vehicle itself. I think I've talked about it already. But what I'll talk about some more are some of the observations that we've had running it. So something impressive is the articulation. So as you see here, with some weight on it, it's pretty amazing, huh? So the shocks are really active. They go all the way. They're laid down here so you could put the bed down. You know, the shock towers are normally here, and that interferes with a true pickup bed. So there's a leaf spring option for this. From what I hear, it's one of the most amazing leaf spring attachments on a vehicle, so that's available. And they chose to go with the coils because it's kind of a performer. And something really impressive is the smoothness of this transmission. I never felt anything like it. You know, the Vanquish is right up there as well. And this one comes with a two-speed. The two-speed is awesome because it's 2.2 times the speed of first gear. So if your first gear is 5 miles an hour, depending on your motor and your gearing, your second gear is going to be 12 miles an hour. So whether you like two-speed or not, you know, I think if you want to save money on the motor, you're not going to go high-end brushless. It is really compelling because what it allows you to do is you can have your high speed, your punch, your fun, and still get your low end control. And what it really allows you to do is really gear down. You know, if you don't need 12 miles an hour, why don't you go gear down, have a top speed of 8 miles an hour, and your low speed control is gonna be so slow. Slow is everything in this hobby. So another fascinating thing, so the servo comes here. We put a Hobbywing 1080 and a Crawlmaster Pro. Links will be in the description for that. The motor, the mesh, is set with this index system. Very nice. And everything is built with precision. Metal shocks, metal connectors, and they're so, even the metal on metal linkage here is so precise. It's built like a watch, basically. So it's free moving. There's not a lot of binding. So I'll talk about the tires. The tires, you know, probably turn off some people from the get-go because they're tiny. You know, they are about 3.4 inches. And to give you an example, we have a RC four-wheel drive over there. That tire I thought was small. It's 3.8 inches. It's on a 1.55 rim, but this is your class one. This is your 4.2 inch, and look how that compares to these. And this is what most of us run. It's a 4.7. So they did not want to do a 4.2. They didn't want to mall crawler it out, so to speak, because it's a working man's truck. It's a scale crawler. And there are options on making the tires bigger. I believe 3.8 is not a big issue to put on this. They sell, when it hits the wheel wells, they sell options on how to do that. But you'll be surprised at the performance with these little street tires. So we can only imagine what's possible with this. So without further ado, without boring you too much, why don't we go to some running video where we go fast, we go slow, we go crawl, we trail, we do everything on basically our first battery pack, because that's what we're all about. So there you go. What do you guys think of the running video? Kind of crazy, huh? How a scale vehicle can perform so well. Something so realistic. One of the advantages is the center of gravity is not that high. Not like this Land Rover we have from RC four-wheel drive. That one's a good vehicle, but this one was like, whoa. And the fact that it's forward biased, the weight really allows it to perform well. And the articulation is amazing. So what do we like? What do we not like? What we liked really is the quality. You know, it's nice to see a kit built with so much care in engineering and precision in manufacturing. And this one has it all. They've thought of things that we've only ever dreamed about. And it's stiff by nature. You know, it has a billet chassis and it does not move. And it doesn't need all these chassis bracing, you know, to make it stiff. It's stiff by nature. It's really built, engineered from the ground up. All the tolerances, the articulation is all there. We thought this thing would not return back because the shocks, when laid down, you know, they don't have that much spring pressure to return it. But that's enough, and they give you option springs as well as you make your bed heavier. So we love that. And really what we love is the precision of the drivetrain. We've never felt anything so smooth. You shift under power. And what happens when you have a very smooth drivetrain is you allow your motor to do the work. It's easy to go slow, but what about going slow when you're taking on an obstacle? Usually you have to load it up with power, and when it releases, it just jumps, right? So this one has hardly any resistance, so it's really able to go slow even under load. So we love that. Steering is amazing. And what else? So everything about it, the tolerances are really good. The wheels are cool. You know, they're very scale and you can flip them, and the offset, it'll get wider a little bit and have a little mag wheel style wheel. We also like the pivot mount on it. We don't like the way it attaches here. You basically need a screw, and it's kind of awkward. We wish they would have given a little thumb screw, so you could just tighten it and maybe have some kind of tensioning, some Loctite on it or something, so it doesn't get loose or fall off. On our test run, one of the shocks came apart. The shocks were built from the factory, but I don't think they were Loctited. So for some reason it made its way loose. So we anticipate the others would as well, probably. So, you know, you have to remember to Loctite everything because it's all metal on metal on this vehicle. So we don't, you know, another thing I'm not so crazy about is, you know, it has a long overhang on the rear, so your departure angle is not good. But that's the nature of scale. You know, they wanted to recreate a vehicle that's quite long, so they stuck with that. It's quite narrow as well. So we want to put this on other vehicles, put other bodies on it, but it is, you have to solve that problem of it being so narrow. A lot of my bodies probably won't work, but I think the axles are so strong that you can just put extenders on it. In fact, they have a dually version of this, four wheels in the back, and the axles have no problem with it, as long as you have the right hardware to attach that. So departure angle, the way the body mounts, you know, tiny tires, you know, it's part of the territory. You don't have shock towers, but you can buy them separately. You know, it'd be nice if they had that in the kit, but, you know, totally understandable. It's purpose built for this, but it's kind of a marriage. You know, when you buy this, you really want, it's really for this body. So that's something you have to keep in mind. You want another body, it's going to take a little bit of work and maybe a little extra money. But really, really fascinated with this kit, you know. So if you were thinking about it, you just needed some kind of validation. I'm no expert, but I've used enough kits. We have a Vanquish. We're going to compare this to an RC four-wheel drive right in its category. And what I can tell you is this is impressive. and it's complete. The tires, the wheels, the beadlocks, the hard body. $630 is a lot, but you know, it's on sale for $599, and it's actually a good value. So on another video, we'll compare it to the RC four-wheel drive, we'll compare it to the Vanquish, and maybe perhaps another video we will explore all the options. It's a whole ecosystem. You can put a bed rack, you can put a tent on the back, you can put a dually, and a lot of these are in the boom racing ecosystem, so you don't even have to go third party. And then third party support, it's all there. CC Hand and all these other companies, they're making parts for this particular model because it's got kind of like a cult following because it's introduced last year, but that's how much people respect the engineering effort that went into this. So hats off to them. Hope you enjoyed the running video. Maybe we'll put some bloopers in the end. And I, like I said, if you are interested in this, make sure you click on our links. So you know, we earn a little bit of credit for the channel to allow us to deliver more reviews like this one. Thanks a ton.